of my first turkey ever.
Run over to him and grab him.
Finally, after 5 minutes of searching,
finally
found my arrow. But good news is, I have my first turkey ever.
On the ground.
On the ground.
On the ground. There he is.
Pretty good too.
Oh yeah, he's good and heavy. Good and heavy. Decent little
nice beard.
9-10 inch beard. Let's
see them hooks.
Yeah, probably.
That doesn't have
inch.
Yeah.
Maybe an inch.
Maybe. Feels good to get out, and my buddy, he's big turkey hunter. I'm more of a deer hunter myself, but he's, you know, we went through training together here over the last 3-4 months, and he said, you know what, we need to get out and we need to do some turkey hunting. And I told him, well, I'll change you. And he said, well, I'll change you. And
this Southern boy had to get this Midwesterner into the long beards. These Nebraskans, too much stuck on their whitetail. Need to get some thunder chickens on the ground. So. Shot at one.
Yeah.
Missed one of them. Snapped his arrow. Clean in half. So we got to looking here. So we got to looking on this bird, and you know it's real good that the landowner lets us hunt this. But he's very specific. We gotta take management turkeys. We can't take no trophy turkeys, just management. And show you how much management this one is. So when he came in, we saw him hobbling, and he said "arr" a couple of times. And as you can see, we're missing a leg here. So we did the landowner some good, got that management bird out of here, and turns out we found his leg here. Kind of crazy how we could, you know,
just stumbled upon it.
He dropped it probably.
Couldn't have been much longer before I shot.
A couple days ago,
yeah,
maybe at the longest, but
just helping a landowner out.
Took him out at the knees. finally got a bird down this morning. About 10 o'clock. Was it 10:05?
Yep.
10:05. Finally got a bird down this morning. Got in a little late. We had to get off work this morning and night shift, so Tyler's manning up hunting.
Yeah.
he's gonna go to bed right after this.
But yeah.
We got on some birds. They worked around us and they left us, and then we just played chase. Played catch up.
Never could get in front of them, yeah, cut them off.
Just played catch up from, and they just kept staying in these cut corn and soybean fields. And right in the middle of them, and there's nothing we could do. So got in the truck. So let's just pull out and go down the road and come in the other side of the property, see if we can get in front of them, cut them off. And man, we finally did. This bird we called Snow White got to about 70 yards and decided to make a hard left. Got behind us and got out in the open. Eventually flew the river to the south side of the property. But his tail does not end here. We'll
catch up with him a little later, but we decided to leave this part and go further west on the property, and we get on another bird here pretty soon, about 6 o'clock. Since this whole calling process started happening, probably 3 or 4 minutes since we heard this bird, and you can see me right up here on top of this hill for a split second, and you realize we're gonna have to make a move because this gobbler is on this other side of this barbed wire fence with two hens, and he's staying, but the hens are leaving, and he will not cross that fence. So we decide here to we have to make a move.
Cross that.
bird we called Snow White we saw on the north side of the river the day before. The bird on the far left now is the same bird. We are now on the south side of the river. So this is the bird that I'm trying to go after.
You got him. Oh man, I'm such a sleep.
Holy cow.
Can't stop the flop.